Hi, and welcome to Best of Friends, the show that really does find out how much your friendship matters to you.
Now, Ronnie, aren't we best friends?
Yeah.
Well, shouldn't I have your number?
Should you?
Yeah. What do you think I'm going to do? Go on, type it in.
All right, then. Here we go.
I'm not going to call you up, like, every 5 minutes or something like that.
All right, then.
Don't worry.
See you later.
Cheers. Thanks, Ronnie. Don't know what's wrong with her sometimes. Yeah, hi, Ronnie. It's Abs. Yeah, what are you up to? Oh, cool. Can I come?
Three tasks.
Three treats.
One's down to luck.
The rest is their choice.
Will they play fair?
Will they play dirty?
Will they still be
the best of friends?
My mate Stephen's a cracker at football. Ryan is a good friend. He's funny and he has a hilarious laugh. Sonny's a really good friend because I sit next to him in class.
Bobby's my friend because I've known him for ages and he's really funny.
James is one of my best friends because he is really, really funny.
That's it, I'm getting a new phone.
Oh, cool, can I have the number?
How are you guys?
Fine!
You're all looking lovely today, can I just say that?
Thank you.
How do you all know each other, Bobby?
Because we all go to Bruton School and us two are cousins.
Cool.
What sort of things do you get up to out of school, Stephen?
Well, football, muck about,
swimming.
Well, I sometimes play dodgeball in the street and stuff.
So, Sonny, what's the worst thing we could ask you to do?
Like pick up horse poo and sweep it up and stuff.
You wouldn't like to mess around with poo?
No,
neither would I. What about you, Ryan? Because you're a bit of a moaner, aren't you, I've heard. Is that true, lads?
Yes.
Yes, it is. So what's the worst thing we could ask you to do?
Touch poo.
I'm seeing a theme here.
Yeah,
no one
yeah.
wants to play with poo. Good knows. How about you, James?
Sliding a pile of goo.
How about you, Bobby?
Stuck with spiders in a small room.
Oh, you look at your face as well. You wouldn't like that either, would you?
No. So you're an all-boys team. Why haven't you got any girls in the team?
Because they'd ruin it.
In what way would they ruin it?
They'd be quite scared of, like, spiders and stuff and they could feel it.
I'm a bit offended here. I'm a girl. I'm not scared of spiders. So let's put your friendship to the test and form your first circle of friendship. Here we go.
All right, then. After three, nice big loud shout. One, two, three.
Respect is due to the Broughton crew.
All right, lads, it's time to tell you what you've got in store. We've got three rounds for you to get through, and at the end of it, there is an ultimate mystery treat.
But first of all, we need to find out who's going on the first task and who's going on the first treat. So we need to bring on your unlucky dip.
Okie dokie.
Now, in this bag are five sweets. Three of them are blue and will turn your tongues blue. If you end up with a blue tongue, that means you're going on the first task.
Now, there are two in there that will keep your tongues clear, and if you get that, well done, because that means you're going on the first mystery treat.
So let's find out who's doing what. Shut your eyes for us, dig in deep to the bag, and good luck.
Right, which three lads are going on the first task?
And then there's just one thing left to say, and that's
you suck!
Will it be Sonny, Ryan, James, Stephen, or Robert?
So after three, we want to see those tongues.
One, two, three.
Show us your tongues. It's Ryan, James and Robert. Take a look at each other. All right, lads, you know what you're doing, so it's time for us to find out what we're doing.
Yep, it's time for the presenter's unlucky dip.
Thank you very much.
Oh,
all right, then, Abs, close your eyes.
OK, no peeking. Right, what do we do now, lads?
You suck!
Thank you very much. All right, boys, don't be distracted. Stop looking at the DVDs, straight past the videos. Don't even look at the CDs, because we're here to do a task, OK? Keep that in the forefront of your mind. Can anyone see an envelope? Because we're where? Good spot. Well done, Ryan. Thank you very much. Should we find out what we're doing? Feeling nervous? I am. OK, good luck. This task is a musical balancing act. Collect 7 CDs by different artists, starting with a different letter of the alphabet, and stack them up on your head. If you drop them, then you have to collect another one starting with the same letter. You have 2 minutes each to collect the correct CDs. If you run out of time, you fail.
The Falkirk Wheel. This is a really good treat. You'll be operating and travelling on the world's first and only rotating boat lift. You'll be suspended at 35 metres up in the air, so we really hope this treat floats your boat. Are you ready to operate this, baby?
Yes!
Let's go then! Excuse me, we've got best of friends here! Thank you!
Now, Ryan and James have got the list of 7 CDs that Bobby has to find. You've got 2 minutes, Bobby. You ready to go?
Yeah.
All right, your time starts now. Shout them out, lads.
All Saints.
All Saints. AL, we're back this way. All Saints, take that one. You all right with that one? Give us a shake. Super girls got it. Okay. All right, lads, next one.
Dido.
Dido. D-I-D-I.
When I found out that my mates were going to do the first treat, I didn't mind because I knew that the second treat was going to be better.
This is number 6. Don't move, don't move. And nice and slow.
So everybody else's turns, I was relieved, but I was going to get the treat and my wish came true.
Okay, ready, steady, go. What's the first
Hives.
Name? Hives. H. Hives, Hives. H-I.
Come on, come on,
this way a bit, right a bit, I think. There's A, H-A, H-E. We got that.
Come on.
How do you spell police? How do you spell it?
K-E-L-I-S. I reckon they will pass the test because they're good in our team.
Okay.
In the next round, I hope I get a task because to make it fair, Ryan, James and Bobby.
Got 2 more to find. There it is.
Well, I thought the first task was a wee bit unfair because to balance 7 CDs on your head is pretty hard.
Try that. Really smart.
I was glad I got the treat because it looked quite fun and high. And it looked, and I got to steer the boat.
Bing bong! We have Sunny and Stephen driving the boat today. I hope you're enjoying yourself.
Okay, Justin Timberlake, there he is. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's number 6.
Good balance.
You're doing so well,
come on,
mate.
What's the next one? Come on,
it's
Ryan.
The last one next. What is it?
Westlife.
Right then, I'll find the CD, you just keep the balance. Oh, well spotted. Doing 2 jobs at once. Stay still, stay still.
Come on.
Okay, go for it. Where's that basket? Bring it up. Take him off his head and pop him in. Go on. Get him in there. Yes! Go on. Good work. Well then, chaps, as you can see, there are 7 CDs in each of your baskets, and the other bit of the task was to complete that in 2 minutes each, OK? Unfortunately, every single one of you was over 2 minutes in completing the task, so all of you have failed the task.
I think it's unfair because we only had 2 minutes and it's impossible.
All right then, taskers, treaters, back together for the first time. Tell us about your treat first of all, Sunny. What did you get up to?
Well, we went up there. We went for a ride in the Falkirk Wheel.
Really? You went all the way to the top?
Yeah.
How high is that?
100.
It's 150.
50 meters?
Yeah,
meters. Wow, that is incredibly high.
You guys, you're off doing your first task. So who's going to tell us what did you have to do?
Well, we went to this record shop and we had to balance 7 CDs in our head and put them in the basket at the end.
So you had 7 CDs on your head. Any you lads good at balancing?
Not really.
So we need to ask the question then.
Did you pass?
No.
All right, then, well, that means in the next round, we still need three people to do a task.
So three of you can volunteer to do the next task, or we can use the unlucky dip. What do you guys think they've done the treat already?
Well, should we just do the task and let them be make it fair?
If you decide to do the task, then we just need one of you, and one of you can either volunteer or we can use the unlucky dip.
I'll go with
unlucky
them,
dip.
But then...
Why would you like to go with them?
It's going to be even tougher this time, so are you sure you're going to be up to the job?
Yeah.
Why should Ryan volunteer? You should all do the unlucky dip.
I know.
Because Ryan's been quite generous, so you should do the lucky dip.
He's got a point.
He's volunteered.
I know. But don't you think that's a bit unfair? Because then he'll have done two tasks and you'll have only done one.
It's his choice.
Okay, well, we need to get to some sort of decision. What's it looking like you're going to do at the moment?
Ryan.
So, two definites.
But you guys have done a treat. You didn't fail the task. So why would you want to volunteer to do a task?
Because I want to see what it's like.
Yeah, I know, because it's not fair. And the other people who just done a task.
And we still need one of you three to go on and do the next task. What would you like to do, Bobby?
I'd like to do the treat.
You'd like to do the treat?
Come on, let him
and James,
treat.
You'd like to do the treat
as
well.
I'll do the last one.
Sonny, what do you want to do?
I'll do the task.
You want to do the task?
I want to do the task.
I'll go over there,
Stephen.
Task.
Task?
Yep.
All right, then. Let's form your second circle of friendship. What we get?
Go on.
Over here.
Yeah. Right.
Here we go.
Are you all in? Okay, after three. One, two, three.
Respect is due to the Broughton crew.
A shame now.
I believe you have a decision for us.
Well, Ryan, Sonny and Stephen are going to do the task and me and Bobby are going to do the treat.
Let's find out who's going with you. Let's bring on the presenters, Unlucky Dip.
Dun, dun, dun.
Okay, go for it. Okay, we've got our sweets. What do we do now?
You suck!
Thank you. You have to prepare a fishy dinner of 10 squid in 5 minutes. Our expert will judge if you have correctly completed your task. It's going to be gut-wrenching. Now, Jill is going to be giving us a demonstration, so watch carefully, because she's only going to do this once. Take it away, Jill.
Right, here we have a squid. First of all, you take your squid in one hand, put your fingers inside and pull gently. And we extract the insides here, okay? Don't worry about this. This is all its tummy and its bottoms and things. Then inside here, there is a bony substance, a bit like your fingernails. Here it is, here. In the old days, they used these like quills for writing in ink, right? What I want is the beak, the head, the quill, and the body in a group together like that for each 10 squid.
Racing carts, that's what we'll be up to today. This treat is all about speed as you get a racing kart track all to yourselves. Best of friends, burn rubber.
Getting a little bit claustrophobic.
When I found out that I was going to go go-karting, I was really excited and started shivering.
Ready, steady, squid!
All right, lads, get your first squid out. Remember what you have to do. Be nice and gentle, but nice and quick. Go on. Oh, nice work. Lay it over. Now, the next thing you've got to do is go for the beak, remember? It's not going to bite, it's dead.
I thought the task was hard because 30 squid in 5 minutes. That's like two squid in a minute. So when we had to, plus we had to pull the beak out and the quill and the whole head, and it was quite banging.
Come on, you got to, that's it.
4 minutes left.
Steven. You have to be gentle but strong. Jill, any more tips?
Just go for it.
I think Sonny and Ryan should do the third treat because Sonny's not been moaning about doing tasks, and Ryan offered to do the second task.
Ryan, you're doing really well there. On your third one.
3 minutes left, guys.
Come on, pressure's on. Let's have a go.
Tomorrow I'm definitely doing a treat because the last two times I've done two tasks. No wonder you're a treat this time. Me, Sonny, Ryan were quite good at it and we were sort of fast and we had good techniques and stuff.
Stop de-squidding. Right, guys, I think you did really, really well. That's not an easy task to do, I have to admit. Ryan, I think your tray is wonderful. Very neat, everything is together and easy to see there. Sonny, you started off really well, got a bit sloppy then, but I think that was a rush job there. And Stephen over here, I like the way you've got your bodies together and your heads together over there. That's pretty good. But I'm sorry to say you've each still got squid left in your buckets there. So I'm really sorry, guys. I'm going to have to fail you on this task.
Oh, I tell you what, I can still smell squid on my fingers.
It's horrible.
Dink. You absolutely reek. You need to jump in the shower later on. You reek, honestly.
I will do. But you should have seen the lads, though, go for it. It was so sad. They were, like, one away from it. It was such a hard task, but they did a great job.
Well, they failed both their tasks, so they're going to need three of them tomorrow to do the final task.
I know. How hard's that going to be?
Shocker.
What's it going to be, though?
I have no idea. Oh, smile. Hi.
Look at the camera.
Hi.
Hi. Did you pout then?
No, I didn't. I changed it.
It's a nice hotel this time. I mean, there's a sewage farm next door, but we can't smell it or anything.
Morning, Riley. You right? Decided to go for a swim next door in that open-air pool this morning. Very nice. Bit stinky, though. Riley? Pembroke turn. Hiya. You all right?
You're breaking right next to me. What are you doing, James?
Well, yesterday when we went on our treat, we were... going go-karting.
No.
With engines.
Cool. Any good at go-karting?
Yeah.
Was it good then?
Great fun.
It was a great treat to have.
Great stuff. We were doing a horrible task yesterday.
We went to Deep Sea World and we were these squids and we had to pull their like insides out and then like their stomach and then we had to lay it down.
That sounds disgusting.
And we had to do 10 of them each in 5 minutes.
Well, what we really need to know is if you passed or failed the task.
We failed it.
But you have got a couple of decisions now to make.
You certainly do. Now, in the final task, we're going to give you three options. Firstly, three if you have to do the task, so you can either volunteer or you can do the unlucky dip.
But we are giving you one more option to see if you want to work together as a team, as five really good mates, and that is that all five of you could volunteer together to do the final task. But remember, you have to bear in mind that if one of you fails, you all fail.
And do remember as well, poor Ryan here hasn't had a treat yet. So you guys need to discuss this, and I'm going to go over here so you can get nice and close. So, excuse me.
We'll just stick here and listen in.
Do you want to do just all 5 minutes?
Because then you haven't had a treat. So, but does it take five to strongest and better chance? I know, but one of five fails, then. We all fail. Because you're doing a lucky dip. Yeah, unlucky dip. There's better chance. I know. If it's five of us, then five. You should have unlucky dip. Unlucky dip. Then three of us will really work hard. Yeah, we'll try our best. Okay, you close to making a decision? Yeah. Well, before we hear it, we're going to form your final circle of friendship. Up my knees.
Getting
a bit old now, a bit old and crinkly. All right, best of luck for the final round of Best of Friends. I'm sure you'll do great.
All right, then.
One,
two, three. Oh, respect is due to the Broughton group.
Now, lads, you've had a really hard decision to make and hopefully you've come to one.
Who wants to tell us what you're going to do? James, go for it.
Well, Ryan's going to go for the treat. Well, me, Bobby, Sonny and Stephen are going to go on the lucky dip.
Four of you are doing the unlucky dip.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, three of you will get blue tongues and that means you've got to do the final task, leaving one other person to join Ryan, who's going to enjoy that final treat.
Is everyone else fine with doing the unlucky dip? Yeah. Is anyone a little bit nervous? You do know if one of you fails, you all fail, and you haven't had much luck yet, have you, with the tasks?
OK, then, let's bring on your unlucky dip.
Thank you very much. OK, boys, in this bag of four sweets, three of them will turn your tongues blue, one will turn your tongue clear.
Ryan, you can take a step back. The rest of you, close your eyes and get ready to pick your sweets. Who'll be joining Ryan on the final treat?
You suck! Will it be Stephen, Sonny, Robert, or James?
One, two, three! It's Stephen!
While the other three get to do the final task. Oh no.
Boys, take a look at each other.
So you chaps know what you're doing. It's time to find out who's coming with you. It's the presenter's unlucky dip. That's another one. Okay, I've got a sweet.
Oh, lovely, and I've got mine too.
Boys, what do we do now?
You suck!
Yes! Off you go! The catwalk. This task will test your memory and moves as you have to learn the steps for a catwalk show, then perform it. Our expert choreographers will judge your performance and completion of moves. Let's see if you're model material. Anyone fancy being a model?
Me.
I'll tell you what, lads, we've got no choice, and let's get this task on the road.
This treat is going to take you up, up and away. You get to bungee trampoline for as long as you like. Have fun. Now, I think the trampolines are all set up over here. You can see some people locked in and flying about. So you ready to go and do it?
Yeah.
All right, guys, let's go.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Now, Jan here is going to show you what to do. So if you go off, Jan, and show the children what to do, if you want to stand over here and watch.
Do you want to get knocked over by Jan?
And after Jan walks down, then we're going to do it one by one.
Okay. Knees and heels.
So who's going to be first then? James? Fantastic. The next step is going to be we're going to do a pose. Fantastic. Pose. That's it. Pose. Okay, guys, we're going to put some music on and practice all the moves that we've learned.
Come on, Bobby. Remember what we said about your feet? Get them in a straight, that's it. Much better. Head up. Head up.
Feel a little bit guilty because they're on the task and I really hope they pass because me and Stephen are on the treat and I hope they get the treat too.
Well, we've all dressed for the occasion. Lads, can I just say, I think you scrub up quite well.
I think you look fantastic. Now, to pass the task, you've got to walk, you've got to turn and do the poses, and we're going to be watching, so good luck.
According to plan, or is it? I don't know if we're actually going to do the task. James, it's up to you. There's no pressure on you. I'm totally on your side. If you don't want to do the task, you don't have to do it, mate, honestly. Last chance. We're going to have to, because it is a task, we're going to have to. Can't do it? You don't want to do it?
Oh dear.
Come on, lads, come in here. Hiya. Marsha, James has something he'd like to say to you.
Well, I'm a wee bit like, I feel I've let down my teammates because I didn't go in. It's just because I was a wee bit scared of publicity coming round.
Oh, what a shame. Unfortunately, to pass the task, it has to take all three of you, and the other two done so well that I'm going to have to fail you. I'm sorry.
How are we feeling, lads?
I think I let them down because I just sort of ruined it for them because we could have been on the treat.
Still best friends?
Yeah.
Respect is due?
Cool.
All right, lads. Thank you very much, fam.
I feel really disappointed about failing the third test because we tried so hard and it ended up that the person that was the best at it didn't do it.
So all my time was wasted on this third task because there was so many things I could have been doing today.
Going over the top, baby!
I found out about my friends, we look out for each other and we don't. Whenever we're doing a task, we don't leave it to one person and we do it together and stuff.
If I had the chance to go on Best Friends again, I would make Stephen do more tasks and make Ryan go on more treats.
Best Friend was about because we'd done all the challenges and when we failed together. It was like we enjoyed it.
The best thing on Best of Friends is we've done some unusual stuff like pulling the inside out of a squid.
When I failed the last task, I felt a bit let, well, not let down, but I'd let my teammates down.
Hello, lads.
Yeah, you on the way?
No, we're not coming. We failed the task.
You what? You failed?
No!
Mate. See you next time on Best of Friends.